Welcome to this recorded service of First Presbyterian Church of Glasgow, Kentucky. We're delighted that you joined us today, either through way of YouTube. If you're watching by YouTube, the recorded service, thank you for watching. Glasgow Electric Plant Board, Channel 6, 11:30 on Sunday. Thank you for watching this 30 minutes of recorded service for you. Today is September 24th, 2023, and this recorded service is for this particular Sunday, the last Sunday we'll have in September. I do want to invite, though, if you're watching this today or following the week, October the 1st is World Communion Sunday. It's a Sunday where believers around the globe join together in the Lord's Supper. On October the 1st, here at First Presbyterian Church, we will celebrate World Communion Sunday. We'll have communion, of course, and we'll also have some special music from music around the world, around the globe. So it'll truly be a global experience here in Glasgow. If you can come join us for worship, please do so, 10 o'clock. October the 1st for World Communion Sunday. We'd love to see you. And I think we'll have some special musicians lined up for that service. And speaking of special musicians, this past Sunday we had a guest string quartet play with us. And in this recorded service, you'll see some snippets of that. And I think next week too, I'll put some video in of our string quartet that was here in this recorded service and the next one for next Sunday. Okay, now on to the message. This is part 3 of 4, and if you've been watching these last few weeks, you'll know that, you know, for 20 years, I've been picking the sermons. But for September, I let the folks in the pews pick the sermon topic. So back in August, everyone that sat in the pews had a chance to write down a sermon that they wanted to hear, or a subject that they wanted to discuss, or a passage they wanted to preach about. So I collected all those, had about 30, and then at random, 4 were drawn for the 4 Sundays in September. The sermon subject that was drawn for today was, when the paper was pulled out, it said, Calling Dr. Howard, a Three Stooges-themed sermon. So, here it is today. This is a Three Stooges themed sermon as requested. So let's start first by the title of the title on the paper when it was pulled out said Calling Dr. Howard. I'm going to try, if I can do it in this recorded service, to insert a little 30-minute clip of the Three Stooges where that Dr. Howard, Dr. Fine, Dr. Howard saying came from. So if I'm successful in that, I'll insert it right now, and you can watch this for 30 seconds.
Calling Dr. Howard, Dr. Fine, Dr. Howard. Calling Dr. Howard, Dr. Fine, Dr. Howard.
And if I was unsuccessful in getting that inserted, you're back to me. I'm not the best with technology. We'll see how it works out. But the Three Stooges, really there were 6 men that played the Three Stooges over the years. There were 4 that were sort of the core group, and then 2 that were not. In that core group of Three Stooges, of the 4 that were the core members, 3 of those 4 were actually brothers. In the late 1800s, there was a young couple in Eastern Europe that emigrated to the United States, to Brooklyn. They came here in the late 1800s from Eastern Europe because they were Jewish, and they wanted to be able to live and practice their faith in freedom. So they moved here, and this young couple, Mr. and Miss Horowitz, they had five boys. Their two oldest sons ended up going into the insurance field. They were respectable insurance agents in New York City. Their three youngest sons, they weren't as respectable as their older brothers. They decided to go into vaudeville, performing on stage performances. And their three younger sons, and notice these biblical names. Their names were Moses Horowitz. Moses became known as Mo, and Horowitz became Howard. That was their Hollywood name, Mo Howard. The other son was Samuel Horowitz, who became known as Shemp Howard. And their young brother, Jerome, who had the nickname Curly. And Curly sort of tagged along with his older brothers, Mo and Shemp, as they went on their vaudeville acts. All right, so those are the three brothers. And the dad was a devout Jewish man. And so he was a man of prayer. And I could see him in prayer when he was raising his kids, saying, "Oh, great Jehovah, please make my three young sons as respectable as their two older brothers in the insurance business." You know, I could see the dad praying that. Well, it turns out the three younger sons became very famous. But the three young sons, the three brothers, Mo, Shemp, and Curly, met another young Jewish guy named Louis Feinberg. Louis Feinberg was from Philadelphia, and he took the name Larry Fine when he got to Hollywood. Louis Feinberg, as a teenager, was an excellent, excellent violinist. In fact, his parents had saved up enough money to send their son, Larry Fine, to Europe to study music in a French conservatory. In other words, they had plans for Larry Fine to be a professional violinist, and they were going to send him to Europe to study violin. Well, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately for Larry Fine, World War I broke out, and the plans to send Larry to France to study in a conservatory went kaput. So Larry began acting on stage. And so the three brothers met Larry Fine, and there you go. There's your core of your three stooges, Mo, Larry, Shemp, and Curly. And the thing I find remarkable is that these men began in the 1920s, and their last live performance was in the 1970s. So for 50 years, they kept their career going. They made contributions to comedy, of course, but also to music. One of their songs in one of their short films was one that resonates with Kentuckians. If you're a horse racing fan, you might appreciate this. One of the musical pieces that was sung by Curly was the song, "She Was Bred in Old Kentucky, But She's Just a Crumb Up Here." That was one. The other musical piece that comes from the Three Stooges is a song called "Swinging the Alphabet." Right? If you're a Stooge fan, you'll remember the song B A B B A B B I Bicky Bi B O Bo, and then all the letters. We actually sang that song in the middle of the sermon during our service on Sunday. But all jokes aside, there's a serious side also to the Three Stooges. That as crazy as they were on camera, they were serious in many ways off camera. They were Jewish. They were family men, especially Mo, Larry, Shemp. You know, they devoted husbands, dads. They took their craft seriously, and so I want to talk about the serious side of the Three Stooges for a few minutes. And they give us an example to follow that I think is a good reminder to us as well. And if you can, I want you to join me now in Proverbs chapter 3. know, in honor of the Jewish faith of the Three Stooges, I'm going to go to the Old Testament, the Hebrew text, for this lesson. You know, these scriptures are ones that they would have read growing up in the synagogue. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 through 10. Proverbs 3, 1 through 10. My son, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and abundant welfare will they give you. Let not loyalty or faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good repute in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your paths straight. Be not wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. It will be healing to your flesh and refreshment to your bones. Honor the Lord with your substance and with the first fruits of all your produce. Then your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats bursting with wine. And this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for it. I want to dwell on verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with your whole heart. Do not rely on your own insight. When we do that, we'll have straight paths ahead of us. Trust in the Lord with your whole heart, not your own insight. That passage reminds me again that when we are brought into the world, when we're stitched in the womb, along with that comes a divine plan for each of us. We all have a plan that God puts in place ahead of us. And our challenge in our life is to follow God's plan and not trust in our own insights. In other words, God's plan's the best for us. It leads us to those straight paths. But so often, we try to outthink God's plan or think we know better, and we use our own insights, and then things get off course. The thing about the Three Stooges I appreciate, and on their serious side, is that they are a good example of how to follow God's plan and not rely on your own insights. I mentioned they had a career from the 1920s to the 1970s, early 70s, a 50-year career. And throughout their career, they just sort of went with the plan. Now think of it like this. If you've ever been to a water park, indoor or outdoor, a lot of these water parks will have something called the lazy river. And the lazy river is a, you know, channel of water about waist deep that has a, you know, a weak current. But if you get in this lazy river with your float, this current will just sort of, you know, meander you through the lazy river, and you stay in the water and you make this big loop, you know. And the current's not very strong. You can walk against it. You can leave the lazy river whenever you want. It's not a strong current. It's a very weak current. But if you get in the lazy river with your float, you'll just sort of float along with the current, and you'll be in the lazy river with 5,000 other people. Usually, you know, it's pretty crowded. I think of God's plan for us like a lazy river. It's a weak current, but it's still there, right? And so if we could just sort of get into the current, the flow of God's plan, and let it carry us, you know, we could always resist it. We could try our own insight. We could leave the lazy river. We could leave God's plan. The Three Stooges in their career, they seem to just go with the flow of God's plan. Wherever it took them is where they went. You know, they started out in vaudeville, on stage, then from there to Hollywood, to Columbia Pictures, where they made those little short films you see on TV sometimes still today. Then from there, they went to live performances and then to making movies, right? Wherever the current took them is where they went. They did not rely upon their own impulses. They didn't try to force the issue. They never said, you know, give us more money or we're out of here or we're going to go on strike or these things. They didn't force it. They didn't trust their own insights. They went with the plan of the Lord and let it carry them in that soft, easy current all the way for a 50-year career. The same is true for me. The same is true for you. In that we too have a current, a lazy river, a current of God's plan that is seeking to pull us to those straight paths, right? And we can resist it, we can get out of that, we can leave it, but if we just sort of let God carry us, go with the flow a bit, wherever God is leading us, that is the example I believe we get from Mo, Larry, Curly, and Shemp. They did that very well. Because if we trust in this soft, easy current of God's direction and don't trust as much our own insight, then we're on the right path. Doesn't God know best? Doesn't God always provide what's best, right? But the thing about going along with God's plan, there's another thing to consider, or to know about at least. When you go with God's plan and let it carry you through your life, wherever it may take you, when you do that, that doesn't mean every day is going to be great. It doesn't mean you'll never have hardship. And I think through the career of the Three Stooges, you know, as they let God's plan carry them without them resisting it, they still had hardships. They had to endure Curly having a stroke while filming on set, and how disturbing that was and how tough that was on them. They had to endure their other colleague, Shemp, you know, dying of a heart attack suddenly. Just tough times. Their contract at Columbia Pictures runs out. They're unemployed for a spell. Had to take day jobs for a little bit, right? So they had their share of difficulty following God's plan. So will we when we follow God's plan. It's not always, every day is not always great. There's still mountains to climb. But here's the punchline. Verse 10. At the end of the lazy river, at the end of letting God lead us and meander us along through life, at the end of trusting God's plan more than trusting our own insights, at the end this happens. Then your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will be bursting with wine. We will have all we need. God's provision will be there. Our barns will be filled with plenty. And with Mo, Larry, Curly, Shemp, certainly their barns were filled with plenty. Even today, you know, their grandkids and great-grandkids are the beneficiaries of the marketing and the use of their images and names. You know, they're still filling the barns well after the years of their death. And as we go through our life following God's divine plan, not trusting our own insights, but trusting in God's plan, letting it pull us ever so gently, at the end of that trip, if we trust in it, we too will discover that our barns are filled with plenty as well. Please join me in prayer. We thank you, Almighty God, for the lessons of Proverbs, for the truth that you have a plan for each of us. It's a plan that's meant for our good, and it's a plan that we could leave whenever we want. We have free will. But give us today the wisdom to pick up on that current, that gentle urging or tugging you put on our hearts. Help us to be in tune with your plan, knowing that when we trust it more than our own insight, we too will get to a place where our barns are filled with plenty. And for that, we give you thanks today in Jesus' name. Amen.
Been there that night. When I got there, I said, yeah, people, they was really having a ball. Yes, I know her. Boogie Chiller. One night I was laying down. I heard Mama and Papa talking. I heard Papa tell Mama, "Let that boy boogie woogie. It's in him.